Sunday's been where a lot of the big happenings have taken place so far this college basketball season. And a packed house here at Allen Fieldhouse, not put off at all by a two-game Kansas losing streak. Big Monday presented by Bud Light. The number three Texas Longhorns are here, and they're undefeated in conference play. Can they extend that run against a Kansas team that you know is hurting right now from that Saturday loss to Arizona? Star watch, a look at the point guards. They're good friends, Dick. Can Aaron Miles shut down his good buddy here tonight?
Well, contrasting styles. Miles, a defensive dynamo, going against T.J. Ford, who's an orchestra leader, who to me is the premier point guard in the land. He is playing absolutely scintillating in Big 12 competition. Miles must control Ford if Kansas is going to get the W here today and break that two-game losing streak.
Andy Katz along with us here tonight at Allen Fieldhouse in Lawrence, Kansas, and we are underway with the Jayhawks getting the opening tip.
I think you can see a very angry Kansas team. Last time they lost three games in a row, Dan, was 1994.
Tough one for Collison, and here comes Ford, and look at him go.
He is so quick, ultra quick.
Has that shot deflected, but Thomas the offensive rebound. Texas on the glass, but they can't finish.
That was a problem in the game against Arizona for Kansas. They were out-rebounded by 10, and they had been out-rebounding their opponents. They didn't do a good job rebounding, and they didn't get to the free throw line in that game.
And we'll be tracking both of those stats here tonight. 3 seconds to call on the horns. This is the only regular season meeting between these two. Last year down in Austin, Kansas won a thriller in overtime, 110 to 103. Aaron Miles only 24% from out there, the miss. Jeff Graves the miss, and both teams have missed follow shots, rebounds inside.
Well, Graves, good offensive rebound, played well in that game against Arizona early before getting into foul trouble.
Thomas, and he is fouled from behind. It looks like Langford, as we check the starting lineups for you. Of course, Kansas still going without Wayne Simeon, who will not play tonight, maybe Saturday, so Jeff Graves has to stay out of foul trouble for Kansas.
There's a look at Simeon, averaging 15.9 a game, shoulder separation. Do they need him in the lineup? When you're talking about a team that's just not looking to get to the big dance, but ultimately try to go for the big prize, they need all their parts, and he is such a valuable part to this basketball team.
Texas is a much deeper team than Kansas is. Texas is without Dejanald Erskine, a good banger, 6'5 forward for them. But the loss of Simeon hurts Kansas much, much more because the Jayhawks just don't have that much depth.
Well, he's such a big-time performer, averaging 15.9 a game, 7 rebounds a game.
Looking for Collison, and Buckman blocks the shot.
Excellent play defensively by Buckman, but then he steps out of bounds. They've been getting such a rotation off their bench, Rick Barnes's club, playing 11 people. Now look at the defense right here. Les Collison going up. Tremendous defense, stays right with him. Texas been really on a run, winning 8 in a row, playing brilliantly defensively.
Buckman just a freshman, McDonald's All-American out of Austin, Texas, number 22, and he's got a tough assignment tonight. And Collison, who breaks free and draws the foul.
Nice move without the basketball by Collison. He started off the year really slow, and then he became Nick Collison, the All-American, and he really went on an unbelievable run when they won 10 games in a row. There he is cutting diagonally without the basketball. Great move without the ball.
Collison averaging about 19 points and 8 rebounds per game. Shooting from outside a little bit more often this year. Actually banked in a 3 against Arizona. And a very good free throw shooter as well at 78%.
Well, you jinxed him right there.
Sorry, Nick. Still looking for our first made field goal of the evening. Brandon Mouton wants to do it. Misses the left-handed reverse.
Looks like a defensive back right there, like Dexter Jackson getting
That's
the MVP
right.
for the Bucks.
I knew the Bucks would come up early. Langford, yes!
He had a big game against Arizona, but it wasn't enough. 27. He went for 11 for 19. He's an explosive scorer. Oh, do I love this little guy with the ball.
Ford, tough look inside. Thomas didn't see it coming. Langford ahead to Miles. Back to Langford. Yes again. Back-to-back field goals for Keith Langford.
Excellent transition basket by Kansas. They're known for taking the turnover and converting the transition. Oh, you got to love this arena, man. One of the great venues in college hoops. The five. Yes, sir. Allen Fieldhouse. Isn't it special
this
first time
great.
For you?
First timer. Loving every minute of it.
Don't make it the last.
Royale Ivy into traffic, and Buckman picks up the garbage and puts it in.
Buckman is going to be such a solid player, rotating minutes now with Bodica, give him that great size off the bench. Rick Barnes told me today before the game, this is the best team he has ever coached. And I'm going to tell you, this is going to be a club that's going to make a legitimate run for the Final Four.
They have been ranked in the top 10 all season. Collison with a baseline drive.
Nobody rotated over, get an isolation one-on-one. Collison shows his ability to get to the basket.
Mouton and Langford, what a matchup on the wing that's going to be tonight.
Tough man-to-man defense. Miles trying to get in the face of T.J. Ford.
Ford knocks down the three. That's his 12th three-pointer this season. He had only five all of last season.
5 for 33 last year shooting the three.
Collison very active tonight, and Buckman wave off the basket, but Buckman has just picked up his second foul.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. Buckman didn't play anybody like Collison on a scholastic level. What an education this is for him right here. There's the isolation. Nobody wrote this. Tate's over.
Buckman's going to have to go out with his second foul. For more on Nick Collison, let's go to the third member of our team tonight, Andy Katz. Andy?
Nick Collison, the first one out here in practice during the shoot-around, but he was very concerned. He told me after the game Saturday in Arizona, he's playing too many minutes, 38 and 39 in his last two games. He needs a breather.
Graves inside.
The big fella lost 35 pounds. They got to keep him out of foul trouble, especially with Simeon not in uniform. Now look at the interior. There's the big wide body. Goes up super strong. He was a little disappointment earlier in the year. They were worried about his conditioning, but he has worked so diligently. And I'll tell you, when they get Simeon back, what a great advantage that is, because now they found another player in Graves.
Had to do a 12-minute run, as all Kansas players do. Had to run 6.5 laps, and it took Graves 9 attempts before he got the required number of laps and was officially made a part of the team. But with Simeon out, Graves becomes an incredibly important player. He had 4 baskets in about a 3-minute span in the first half against Arizona, but then got in some foul trouble in the second half and didn't score again.
That was one of the wackiest games in college basketball. Up by 20 and then lose by 17 at home.
Good find. Ford to Sid Mill Harris. 3-point shooter misses it. Ford with the 15-footer.
Under control, T.J. Ford. Good rebounder for a little guy as well. So is Miles.
Well, what a great pace we've got in the first 4 minutes of this game here tonight.
They're going to play off Miles. They don't respect his ability to shoot from the perimeter. See how he's playing off him? T.J. says, get him. I'm going to let you shoot that. You can take that shot.
Collison on the drive. Takes a bump. Back rim. Gets it back. Off everybody's fingertips. Out of bounds. Over to Texas.
Miles is going to have to try to at least take some shots to make Ford respect him and come on him, because they're trying to jam inside and take away any kind of passing lanes to Collison.
And again, these guys are good buddies. Ford and Miles. Ford knows Miles' game very well, and vice versa. Ford looking for the three again. Collison got held, but still got the rebound.
Heinrich's got to get some shots.
Pulls up at the foul line. Rattles out for him. And the rebound comes down to Brian Boddicker.
Last two games, he was 9 for 30 in the two losses. They can't win unless Kurt Heinrich and Nick Collison are All-Americans and play up to their ability.
And we have 3 consensus All-Americans in the game tonight, along with Ford of Texas. Mouton inside, lays it up and in, and the Longhorns take the lead.
He had 20 against Missouri, blew Missouri out in the second half. Missouri has it tough on the road. They got to learn how to win away from Missouri country.
Langford, the lefty, misses the mid-range jumper. Of those 27 against Arizona Saturday, 22 came in the first half for Keith Langford.
He went 11 for 19.
Boddicker can shoot it from out there. With Boddicker and Sidabelle Harris in the game, the Longhorns have a couple of lethal outside shooters.
Well, that was created by the look by T.J. Ford. So unselfish. Led the nation as a freshman in assists last year. First time that's happened.
You saw the rebounding numbers. It's been a problem for Kansas in each of their last two games. Losses at Colorado and here against Arizona.
L.A. had 27 against it for Colorado.
Off the fingertips of Heinrich, out of bounds, and the visiting Longhorns with a 4-point lead. As always, getting some production off the bench, Brian Boddicker knocking down the three.
Here's Boddicker, baby. Nothing but nylon. He gets the dish from little T.J. Ford.
Texas leading Kansas by five. Rick Barnes upset after Terrell Ross took that shot to the face and had to come out of the game with an injury. Coach Barnes has led Texas to maybe the best run in its history. Only Kansas has a better record in conference in the last 4.5 years, and only by a game and on the road. And like in this league, like any other league, Dick, it is so hard to win on the road. The Longhorns have been the best in the Big 12. They are ranked third in the country. They were number two earlier this season. This is a legit Final Four contender.
Well, you know, last year they go to the Sweet 16. They beat Boston College, beat Mississippi State, and lost a heartbreaker to Oregon, 72-70. And this club is a veteran club, knows how to win, well coached. Got a bunch of tough kids, got size, you got balance inside, outside play.
Their losses this year to Notre Dame and Arizona.
Lost a heartbreaker to Arizona.
Plotts strong off the bench so far tonight, but Collison stays with it.
And that loss to Arizona, Jason Gardner took over late in that game, but they played without Luke Walton.
Yep, 73-70, Arizona there. Look at Collison running the floor.
He's playing so much better than what you and I saw out of New York when they lost to North Carolina and they lost to Florida.
5 points and 6 rebounds already for Nick Collison.
This crowd is alive. I love the enthusiasm and energy here.
Ford with a good find to Thomas, blocked from behind by Langford. Plots the follow, and Collison with his 7th rebound of the night.
Fatigue could become a factor because a guy like Collison's going to have to play a lot of minutes.
Misses the three. Lee keeps it alive, but we've got a foul on Kansas. Michael Lee is called.
Roy Williams, you talk about a future Hall of Famer. Over 400 wins. Look at Collison. Nice little drive to the basket. Hangs in the air. Gets into the 3-second area. When you think of Roy Williams and you think of what he's achieved in his tenure here, averaging 27 wins a year. Some guys get 20 games a season and it's a great thing. This guy averages that.
15th season here at Kansas. Led him into the Final Four last year. Third time that he's done that.
91 and 93 as well.
Miles out right now. Heinrich defending Ford, and Ford knows he's quicker, but he misses the shot. Gets it back, and he's blocked. Thomas gets it back, and a foul on the Jayhawks.
I tell you, there's no place for the weak on the interior here. Thomas, look at that body. He's got some guns, Dan Schulman. He's got guns like you, my man. Take a look at him. Look at the block on TJ. And Mr. Thomas gets it. He's a double-double guy. Averaging 10 points a game, 11 rebounds a game.
Big foul on Kansas. Number two on Graves.
Third one would be major, yep, because they have no size on the bench that can give them the kind of quality time to play the likes of Thomas, Bonica, Buckman.
Let's get an update on the injury to Terrell Ross. Here's Andy.
Well, he's actually fine. He just got poked in the right eye. They put a little drops in his eye, and the trainer told me he'll be back in the game without a problem.
Andy, give me a report. I know you were at practice yesterday on Simeon.
Simeon was hitting everything in his everything around the three-point line, but I just spoke with Roy Williams right before tip-off. He said it's still not decided. In fact, he said it's not even close in his mind that he would play Saturday against Nebraska.
Might have to sacrifice a game or two now to get him back healthy and ready to go later on in the season. Let's look earlier today as Texas is called for a foul. Sidnell Harris, this is Simeon several hours ago just working on his own. It was a dislocated right shoulder, his shooting shoulder, suffered 7 games ago. And you can see he's got that arm in a sling, it looks like, as he's in street clothes over on the bench. Back to Andy.
That's certainly devastating one loss, Andy.
One other thing that Nick Collison told me is the practice before the Colorado game where he tweaked the right shoulder, and that made him a little bit gun-shy to come back too soon.
Simeon out. Graves in, but playing with 2 fouls. Kansas down 4 here at home. Big Monday presented by Bud Light. Number 3 Texas, number 13 Kansas here at Allen Fieldhouse as the Jayhawks try to avoid their first 3-game losing streak in 9 years. Texas so big and strong inside, and as you can see, capitalizing on the offensive glass. Tomorrow night, more hoops coming your way. here on ESPN. Super Tuesday, a terrific doubleheader. Dick and I will be up at the Breslin Center to see the struggling Spartans. Boy, does Tom Izzo's team need a win. They've lost 6 out of 8. Indiana hoping to have Bracy Wright back in the lineup. And then number 4, Florida at Baton Rouge to take on LSU. Remember, LSU on that court defeated Arizona earlier this season.
I'll tell you one thing. They need Bracy Wright down there in Hoosier Country coming off that blowout. What about a salute for Gene Katie? I mean, in 2000, they go to the Elite Eight, and people forget. Last year, he has a tough year. They play without Lowe. Lowe and Dean were brilliant against Indiana.
Moulin Yan with a good hustle play to steal the ball and draw the foul.
Moulin Yan is a guy that's going to have to give him some minutes. There he is hustling. That's just pure John Madden-style hustle. He'll make the All Madden team. Hey, by the way, Roy Williams is from, coached at Owen High School, and that is also out in a Black Mountain, North Carolina, where Brad Daugherty lives, and also where Brad Daugherty went to school. Brad Johnson, the QB of the Tampa Bay Bucks.
Coach Williams knows Brad Johnson and his dad. Yannick for Collison right now. Yann didn't start playing basketball until he was 14 from Senegal, and soccer was his sport.
See, right now you're in Texas. You got to take advantage of that experience inside. I'd pound the ball inside.
That's what they're doing, and they draw the foul.
That's smart basketball. That's good basketball IQ as a team. Taking advantage of it while Collison is on that sideline.
And this is a desperate situation right now for Kansas. This foul went on Graves, his third, as he tried to slap the ball away. So Collison's going to come back in, but now Graves is going to have to go out.
Yeah, that's a major loss. He got 3 fouls in the second half against Arizona in about a minute. Hey, you talk about defense. You and I saw some defense Saturday. Kentucky with that suffocating defense now won 9 in a row. Tubby Smith's club, just like Texas, is a legit Final Four contender. And so will Kansas. I really believe that Kansas, if they get back a healthy Simeon, they're going to get back into that groove they were when they ripped off 10 in a row. They were just finding their rhythm.
Because then Graves could come off the bench, not play as many minutes. Without Simeon, now with Graves in foul trouble, Collison has to come right back into the game after a very quick rest. And again, Kansas right now more inexperienced and less size than this Texas team. Texas and Arizona may be the two deepest teams in the country, and it's no surprise why they're ranked in the top three.
Very deep and a lot of quality. Kentucky very deep, but doesn't have the offensive weapons, but they really do it in a very unselfish way defensively.
Pittsburgh ranked number 2. They're deep, not 10 deep, but 8 deep, really. Great help off the bench, and another great point guard in Brandon Knight. All the top teams have really strong point guard play and a lot of depth.
You're not going to win without an orchestra leader. That's why Maryland now is playing really well. They feed off Steve Blake. Drew Nicholas has become an all-ACC player. You look at our top 10.
Yeah, just came out 6 o'clock Eastern today. The ESPN USA Today coaches poll. Texas moved up to 3 as Duke dropped after their loss, and Kansas went from 6 down to 13. And look at Louisville at number 8. What are you going to circle?
Well, I'm going to tell you right now, this is a team I really like right there, Florida. I really love their ability with their young people, Roberson and Walsh. They have the veterans as well with Bonner and certainly Nelson and the experienced people.
Florida at LSU tomorrow night here on ESPN, and a week from tomorrow at Rupp Arena.
Florida, Kentucky. And then it's Carolina and Duke, and that's always special down there with the Cameron Crazies, who to me right now are like the most valuable player for the Dukies because they're a different team at home. Their young people have to learn how to mature in basketball and play on the road. And Mike Krzyzewski will make that happen.
Something that Texas has learned how to do on the road in hostile territory. They're up by 8.
On the road again, baby, on the road.
As we kick off the new week, Big Monday presented by Bud Light. Connecticut already defeating St. John's, and now here Texas trying to pick up a big road win over Kansas. Let's look back at Dickie V's weekend headline.
Well, what about Tommy Amica now? 13 in a row after going 0-6. Beats MSU for the first time in 9 tries. Utah under Kerry Rupp. That's right, the assistant took over for Rick Majerus. He had to go to the funeral for Andre Miller, his former player's stepdad. And they end the 44-game home streak for BYU. Kentucky to end a 28-home game win streak for Alabama, and Alabama's struggling, only 2-4 after being number 1 in America at one time. 9-0, they were number 1 in America before going to Utah.
Kansas right now with another struggle, down 8. Graves on the bench with 3 fouls. Collison playing with 2 fouls, as is Michael Lee off the Kansas bench. Langford somehow finds a little room, but had to alter the shot. And there are not many second opportunities for Kansas. Let's go to Andy Katz.
Well, Kirk Heinrich checking back into the game. He's had a minor cut above his right eye. They've been putting these Band-Aid strips on there that have been causing some problems and falling off, as you see here on the screen. But they keep working on it. He should be fine for the rest of the game.
All right, Andy. He's got 6 points so far in this game. Kansas is getting out-rebounded 21-11 right now by the bigger, stronger Horns.
Not surprised when you look at the depth that Texas has in terms of their baseline.
There it is. Only two players for Kansas have any rebounds in this game. Collison has 7 and Graves has 4. They're going to get some of the perimeter guys getting some rebounds right there.
Langford's got to give him some help.
Miles on the drive.
He's got to use his offensive ability to get to the basket. That's his strong suit. Not shooting the perimeter jump shot, but he can attack the basket. He's a good athlete. He's a tough kid. Leads the conference in assists.
A step out there by Collison. Ford keeps the dribble alive, though. Swings it cross court. Boddicker, another 3.
How many kids could make that pass? That was absolutely the creativity of T.J. Ford. Great vision.
Third assist of the night for T.J. Ford. And Boddicker, off the bench, has 3 threes and 11 points. Miles an air ball. Collison with the foul.
Collison with a good offensive rebound. But Boddicker's been doing that. You look at the last 4 games, his stats averaging 11 points a game and making the 3. But it's the orchestra leader. That's right, the maestro man right there. He has improved his range as a shooter. He is absolutely separating himself from all the other point guards in America now. This kid is becoming a dominant force.
And look at the joy that he plays with, the expression on his face as he goes up and down the court, having as much fun as anybody in the building.
Trying to get some shots for Collison. Nobody else. Everybody else standing around.
You're not going to catch this guy. T.J. Ford into double figures, and it's a timeout for Kansas.
T.J. Ford, one of America's, you're being treated, people. Watching one of America's finest people. This kid can flat out play. You're going to take a look at him. Watch his vision right here. You're going to see great court vision. He's going to isolation, use the screen, freeze him right here. He's already looking. He knows he's going to have a guy throwing a ball diagonally. Take a look right here. There he is now coming in. Look at that vision. He's going to go diagonally with the pass. There it is. Unbelievable. And now the other part that makes him lethal, Dan Schulman, his ability now to improve his jump shot. And then he combines the shooting ability with the speed, the quickness. He's ultra quick.
He's a sophomore.
Yeah, played high school at Willow Ridge High School out in the Houston area with Daniel Ewing.
Wow, can you imagine that?
They were dynamite together.
11 points, 4 rebounds, 3 assists, and Rick Barnes, maybe the best point guard in America, his team on another run. Kansas undermanned a little bit, don't have the depth. They're in some foul trouble right now. Heinrich with another long 3. This one rattles out, and Klotz is there to make sure there's no second shot.
You can almost feel that Heinrich and Collison really feel the pressure of having to carry this club, having to look at almost every possession for a shot because they don't have the help that they had last year around.
With Gooden and Boshi. In the game last year against Texas, Drew Gooden had 28 points. Jeff Boshi hit 6 threes and had 21 points.
Well, that was common denominator for them all year, those guys.
Klotz doesn't stay down. Rebound, Collison. Let's get some more from Andy Katz. Andy?
Well, I'll tell you, Kirk Heinrich and Nick Collison both told me they really feel the pressure of carrying this team. It's been a huge responsibility on them. In fact, Heinrich told me it's harder to be a star than a complimentary player, and he's having some trouble with it.
Psychologically, that's a whole different area, Andy, dealing with that.
Well, we got some bodies flying as Texas is called for the foul. I think it's going to be Boddicker.
Because they are such kids, when you talk to Kansas kids, great kids with such a passion for wanting to succeed that they put such pressure on themselves.
To the line, Bryant Nash, 6'6 junior. And a guy who's averaging just about 2.5 points per game, does not play very much. You can see what Heinrich and Collison are doing. They are trying to hold up their end of the bargain. But with Graves on the bench and foul trouble, some of the complimentary players like Nash or Nyan or Lee, they've got to get something from their bench.
Last time they lost 3 in a row was in 94, as we said a little bit earlier. Lost to Oklahoma State, Missouri, and Nebraska. But they've had so much success here, dominating the opposition. When you look at Roy in his 13 years, I mean, he won 8 conference titles. I mean, incredible. 4 tournament titles.
trying to give the Jayhawks some support. They're back within seven after being down 11 moments ago. Mouton over Langford. What a strong move by Brandon Mouton.
You know, in their two losses, he averaged 5.5 a game against Notre Dame and Arizona. But he's averaging now, in the last seven, eight games, 14 points a game.
And shooting just about 50%. What a balanced team Texas is offensively. Nobody averaging better than 14 points per game, but seven players averaging at least 7 points per game. Collison spins to the baseline, and Thomas is there to get it. Crowd wanted to foul on Klotz.
Thomas is one of those guys. He's really an unbelievable Windex man.
Another unpopular call is Jeff Hawkins, a redshirt freshman, into the game, gets called for the foul. And Roy Williams trying to get some future calls out of Ted Hillary.
Well, you got an experienced crew here today. You talk about guys that have pulled a lot of big games in Hillary, Wilmer, and certainly in Tommy O'Neill. O'Neill had that big confrontation between Oklahoma and Oklahoma State.
A couple of weeks ago, that controversial shot with a few seconds to go in the game right at the end of the shot clock. Big moments on Big Monday so far this year. Heinrich, no. Texas on the run. Ivy, yes.
Ivy, a starter last year, a kid out of New York City. They got so many weapons. I mean, to go to that bench with guys are proven players.
Already seven different Longhorns have scored in this game. Collison, he'll go to the line for two.
I mean, they're only a couple moments away from being undefeated and number one in America. Yep. A heartbreaking loss to Arizona and certainly to Notre Dame.
They have achieved the highest ranking in the history of the Texas basketball program this year. That was number two in both polls back in December. They are number three right now, with Arizona being number one and Pittsburgh being number two.
You know, I look at Collison on that line. By the end of the year, he continues to roll. Look at Rick Barnes with a little hug around him. Hey, look at this. Going to take him out for dinner. Look at Rick. Since you come down to Austin, he's smiling, feeling good. Up 10, up 11, up down 9.
Why not? Texas trying to make it three losses in a row for Kansas. Carl, thank you very much. Well, a nice moment here in Kansas before this game tonight. Texas leading the Jayhawks by 9. Norm Stewart, the longtime coach at Missouri, was honored before the game for the creation of the Coaches versus Cancer three-point shooting program, which has raised better than $16 million today. And Coach Roy Williams said, for so many years, the folks here at Allen Fieldhouse kept saying, sit down, Norm, sit down. They finally gave him a rocking chair, and Norm was finally happy to take a seat.
And that's his beautiful wife. Virginia is just absolutely a lovely lady. What the wives have to go through is so special. Norm has done an amazing job with the Coaches versus Cancer. We just learned recently another player that we watched and admired playing at Alabama, Jim Farmer, is now battling cancer. It was Jim Arbest. Played with Mark Gottfried down there in Alabama in the mid-80s. Norm has battled cancer, and he's done really a phenomenal job living now in California down at Palm Springs, along with Gene Bartow, Bob Boyd. They all get together down there. Life's pretty good. He overachieved in marriage, too. I mean, look at that sucker. That's hey, help hey, for all you hey. Guys out there.
Well, most of us did, don't you think?
I agree. I know I did.
Klotz cannot convert the three-point play. Another great find on that last play, by the way, by T.J. Ford. His fourth assist of the night. Langford, look at him slither inside. Misses the shot. But Collison, with the rebound and the putback, he's already got a double-double with 11 points and 11 rebounds.
Well, you expect that out of him. The veteran player in All-American preseason. There is a block shot. He's playing a super first half. He needs a little help from some of his people around him.
He sure does. He's the reason they're in it. They're trying to get through some foul trouble.
Dump it in now.
Halftime.
So you're going to look to double up on him.
Baseline fadeaway, too short. Rebound, T.J. Ford.
Great defense to make him spin away from the basket.
There is nothing you can do. Can you imagine the feeling that Hawkins or anybody else must have backpedaling and Ford's coming right at you?
I'll tell you one thing. That guy coming at you, you got a better idea than this? Look at this here, a little shake and bake. I mean, trying to reach around him. What a change of direction. A little showtime. He's got the whole game, baby.
To the line. Big first half, as you can see. As mentioned, Carl Ravitch, Digger Phelps coming up with the MassMutual halftime report. Some off-the-court time with Brandon Mouton of Texas. A recap of the first game of the Big Monday triple header as UConn picks up a road win at St. John's and a coaching change
wow,
for the Detroit
wow.
Lions.
Could it be? Could it be? A guy from the 49ers,
your guy?
Maybe?
Your guy?
Oh, Mariucci, come back with Izzo in the state of Michigan. I hope that happens. spins. They gave him a raw deal out there with those 49ers. So unfair.
Langford, a much improved shooter this year.
Trying to get that angle inside. Nice look. Touch pass by Kyle. Screen and roll. Trying to pound it inside.
Miles. Oh, everything but the finishes. It rattles out. A loose ball to Kansas. Haven't been many of those tonight.
Can't get a lot of good looks for Heinrich.
Heinrich with 6 points, 2 of 5 shooting in the first half. Langford to the baseline. Hangs and hits.
That's a big time move. Fort Worth, Texas, would like to do something against his buddies from out of the university, the state university, one of the great state universities in the country.
Langford so consistent this year in double figures in every game but one. Four drives. Kicks it to Mouton. Rebound, Collison.
Collison looks so good. Look at Heinrich run the court.
And he takes a shot and he'll go to the line.
Super job of getting out in transition by Kirk Heinrich. You gotta love the ability of Collison and Heinrich. Anybody that doesn't like those two kids don't understand basketball. Both played for their dads in high school. Came out of the state of Iowa.
That's right.
Steve Orford, if he's coaching it now, he said, hey, I'm not gonna let those two guys ever get out of the state. Players of that quality.
Somebody asked Coach Roy Williams a while ago about, you know, do you like getting kids who play for their dads in high school? And he goes, wouldn't you like to get a coach's kid? I mean, they just understand the nuances of the game so well. And both great kids and unselfish basketball players as well.
You know, Texas had a few moments in this game where they really had Kansas on the ropes. Looked like they could knock them out. But the Kansas kids won't let them knock them out. And a lot of that's attributed, I think, to right here playing at home, these fans.
Ted Hillary is going to turn the call around. T.J. Ford is smiling. He knows it was out on him, and Kansas will get the ball back.
He plays with such a beautiful attitude. The coach's dream, man. It's a coach's dream. Look at T.J. T.J. knocks it out. No. T.J. knocked it out.
T.J. or Moulay? Now, T.J. didn't argue. He smiled, so they'll give it back to the Jayhawks without much of a fuss.
I believe T.J. is not our producer, Dan Steer.
Oh, what a rebound by Nash.
He's a big-time athlete. He's got athletic ability. Oh, that's a... Look at that rage.
Oh!
Are you kidding? Oh! What rage! He shot that from Kansas City! He shot that from Kansas City! He shot that from Kansas City! They are back! The Jayhawks are back! They won't go away! As a T.O., baby, by T.J. Ford! Here. This is the line. Are you kidding me? That's an NBA and beyond. I mean, look at this rage. Kurt Heinrich, one of America's special players, had an injury earlier this year. Certainly didn't allow him to perform at the level he's capable of playing.
He's led the Big 12 in three-point shooting each of the last 2 years, and you can see why. Hey, if you want to see a guy with some deep range, if Bracy Wright is healthy and back in there dealing with that bad back, you're going to see an Indiana guy who could shoot just like Heinrich as they take on Michigan State tomorrow night. Super Tuesday presented by Dollar Rent-A-Car, and then a big matchup of the SEC. The Florida Gators unbeaten in conference play down in Baton Rouge. T.J. Ford with the answer.
I tell you, what a way to silence the crowd. You go right to your all-Rolls Royce, and he delivers solid goal, T.J. Ford.
Hey, don't you think, unless this gets out of hand in the last 30 seconds, with Graves in foul trouble, Collison on the bench right now after a huge half, Roy Williams has to be pretty happy with where his team is. They could have gotten blown out a few minutes ago.
I know the point you're making, but knowing Roy Williams, what a competitor and winner he is, he's absolutely never, ever satisfied being on a negative side, especially at home.
But as you said, Texas was up 9-11, and it could have gotten to more than that.
I know the point you're making.
Heinrich trying to take over. Finds Miles for three.
Why doesn't he shoot a little bit more often? I mean, the kid has got to shoot the ball to make people at least try to play him.
Look at Ford trying to answer. Buckman slams it home at the buzzer, and Texas goes to the break up 5.
What an unbelievable play by Buckman. Just a tremendous offensive rebound by the diaper dummy. Look at Barnes. He's going to like that. He's going to like that. Look at TJ. Now here comes Buckman. Right here. Down the gut of the defense. There he goes. Great play on the offensive glass. Nobody boxes out. What a great first half. What a fool. I mean, it's an unbelievable fight. You not get
it doesn't get better. You a little bit more.
Not really.
The Texas Longhorns with their highest scoring first half of the season. Roy Williams of Kansas down five right now to Texas. 48-43 here in Lawrence. T.J. Ford, one of the stars of the first half here tonight. Texas takes a five-point lead into the second half here at Allen Fieldhouse in Lawrence, Kansas. Dan Schulman, Dick Vitale, a couple of point guards, a couple of buddies, a couple of number 11s, and the two guys we looked at in the Star Watch, and I think both point guards have to be pretty pleased with the way they played in the first half.
Oh, T.J. Ford has really become such a scoring dominating player as well as a penetrator. In the first half, he scores, and look at assists, the turnovers, 4-0. Miles, 6 assists, 0 turnovers. He leads now, Miles, the conference in assists. But I'll tell you, Ford, the difference was he scored 14. Miles had 7. I look now at the stats right here, the bench. 17 for Texas. We expect that. A 4-1 ratio versus Kansas off the bench. And then look at the field goal shooting right here. Bottom line is Collison had a great first half. Will he wear down, or will he have something available for the second half? Because he had a good first half against Arizona. And second half, he struggled against Arizona.
Generally this season, Texas has been a better second half team, and Kansas has been a better first half team. You could say it's got something to do with their depth, both teams. Roy Williams doesn't think their lack of depth is that much of a problem, that they get tired. He thinks foul trouble can be a problem for them. And Jeff Graves does start the second half with 3 fouls. He gets loose inside and is fouled by James Thomas. Let's get an update on the Longhorns. Here's Andy Katz.
Well, at halftime for Texas, their main concern was getting the basketball in the paint. They want to just pound it inside like you just saw to James Thomas. They want to try to get it inside as much as possible, and that's what you see T.J. Ford trying to do, a little 15-footer for James Thomas. Also, they got it defensively, at least from the coaches, cut off Kansas's transition baskets.
Number 3 on James Thomas. Graves to the line, Thomas to the bench, as Klotz, who had a very nice first half, comes back in for Texas.
You know, James doing a great job rebounding. I see the name Thomas, I think it's Jamel Thomas, who used to play at Providence. But James certainly doing a good job rebounding, not scoring on the inside. But in a case with Texas, they got enough bodies they can rotate in on a baseline.
There was a time when Texas had a 13-point lead late in the first half, but Kansas at one point being outscored 10-0 in second chance points, even at the break at 12. They got a lot of offensive rebounds late in the first half, and it made them count. It's out of bounds off Texas, back to Kansas.
You know, the point Roy Williams was making to us before the game was, you know, I'm not worried about fatigue. Our players are in great condition. They can play. What he worries about is the foul trouble, because now he has to get the quality players off the court, and that's what creates a problem. I mean, Collison had 13 rebounds in that first half, in addition to his 11 points.
Heinrich had some very big outside shots for the Jayhawks toward the end of the first half.
Trying to get a little screen and roll with Collison.
Frankfurt inside to Graves, and he's stripped. Here comes Ford. Look at that bounce pass, about a 35-footer to Mouton, who scoops it home.
Mouton could score in a variety of ways. He can shoot the perimeter shot. He can attack the basket.
Miles attacking Ford. Yes!
That's smart. Miles has got to do more of that. He's capable of going to the basket. He's got great quickness. He's such a good kid, too. Great basketball IQ. So unselfish.
Well, what a matchup we've got going here between Texas and Kansas. They went to overtime last year, and they're close here tonight. Buckman misses the jumper. Miles on the rebound.
This is life in the Big 12, my friend.
Miles pushing and scoring again.
Miles said, hey, TJ, anything you have, I got. TJ says, no, man, I'm the Rolls Royce. But the Rock Chalk Jayhawk fans jump with joy, including JoJo White, who they hung his jersey up on the rafters.
Ford with the answer, and he's shushing the crowd on his way back down.
Says, anything you can do, Aaron, I can do better.
Ford averaging 14. Already has 16. There's Collison banking one home. What a night he is having.
It's great to see the superstar players respond. To respond under pressure. What action here tonight. Big 12 basketball at its best. Texas and Kansas.
Ford penetrates. Oh, no basket.
Oh, they
no
wave
basket.
It off. They wave it off. We're going to watch Aaron Miles. Look at his point guard. He's going to take it to the goal. There he is, taking it strong, super quick. And now we're going to watch the All-American go to work. A little shake and bake. I tell you, he reminds me so much. Years and years ago, my favorite point guard of all time played at North Carolina, Phil Ford.
An forced error there by Texas as Mouton throws it away.
I thought Phil Ford was the best point guard I ever watched on a collegiate level. As you look at the numbers tonight, he's over his average 13.9. Last year, averaged 10 a game. See, he was a little unselfish last year. He was trying to get everybody else to rock, led the nation in assists.
3-point lead, Texas. Graves playing with three fouls. Looking inside, Collison having a huge night.
Doubling up, as soon as the ball goes inside, they double him up.
Langford loves to penetrate, and he brings Kansas back within one. Langford, very superstitious, Dick, about his footwear. If he doesn't have a first half, he goes to a new pair of shoes, and he did it here tonight.
I tell you, he can score.
Oh, he can pass. How about that dish from Ford to Ivy?
I mean, he can throw it, put it on a dime, give him another dime, Mr. T.J. Ford.
Seventh assist of the night for Ford, right about his average. What a game this is. Collison, and he draws the foul.
T.J. Ford has that unique vision that is so special. We're going to take a look right now. Watch him make the backdoor cut. Look at the backdoor cut on the baseline, created by the passing ability and the vision. I mean, we talk about vision. Special people have it. Basketball awareness. He has a great basketball IQ. Loves to win. A passion for playing. Look at even Steve Wilbur says, I like that passion there.
Let's get a little bit more about T.J. Ford. Once again, Andy Katz.
Well, I'll tell you, James Thomas told me yesterday the one thing that was lacking in T.J. Ford's game was the vocal leadership. He said that he needed to be much more verbal over the rest of the season. T.J. Ford said he's doing a much better job of that, and you can see that. He's talking to the officials. He's talking to Aaron Miles. He's talking to everyone.
Well, you know, Andy, I think for some people it's very difficult. I was always shy and introverted, so it's tough for me to talk. You know, Andy,
I don't buy that.
I mean, certain people just really don't have that about. But I'll tell you one thing, he talks when the ball's in his hands, man. He talks big time. Luke Graves got to watch for that fourth. Nice deflection.
Hey, well, Big Monday's been pretty special so far this season, and it will continue tonight at midnight Eastern, presented by Bud Light. Mountain West action, UNLV taking on New Mexico with the two leading scorers, Reuben Douglas and Marcus Banks, are the leading scorers in the conference, and they'll be on display. So stay up late and watch some more great Big Monday action. Let's see who it goes on. Every time there's a Kansas foul, Roy Williams holds his breath to wait and find out who it's on.
13 consecutive NCAA berths in his 15-year tenure. 13 consecutive 20-game win seasons, three Final Fours, eight conference championships. Roy Williams destined for the Hall of Fame. I mean, that is a lot.
Mouton at the line for Texas.
He'll be a part of that coaching staff with Larry Brown, the former Jayhawk leader.
Popovich and Oliver Purnell.
He's doing a heck of a job down at Dayton. And look here at the Final Four journeys. NCAA champs in 1988. We heard about Danny Manning's new house today.
That's sweet.
Yes, sir. At lunch, we went to dinner with a man that's building his house here in Lawrence.
Now, Danny Manning did not play under Roy Williams. Played under Larry Brown, but he still lives here, and he practices with these players all the time. He's still a very big part of the Kansas program.
It was Danny and the Miracles in 1988. They were 12-8 at one time. Looked like they were going to go to the NIT.
Four to Mouton. He knew he missed it. And we've got a foul. Which way is it going to go? Everybody's looking around. And it's going to be Graves, I believe, and that is his fourth.
And that's the one thing Roy was concerned about when we were in his office tonight. He said, I cannot afford to have Collison or Graves get in a foul trouble. And this game is really significant to Kansas. I mean, you lose two games in a row, and you're Kansas, and you're a big-time program fighting for national honors. You want to avoid certainly three in a row, especially two in a row at home.
One of these moments where we say mark down the time and the score, 16:09, and a three-point lead for Texas when Graves went out. Bryant Nash comes in, and can the Longhorns take advantage?
Trying to double up on four. That's usually a disaster when you try that.
Somebody's got to be open. There he is. It's Mouton flashing to the bucket. Rebound for Collison, his season-high 14th.
13 was that high. 19 is his career high, and that was against Seton Hall, who, by the way, got beat today by Manhattan.
Another big win for Manhattan.
Bobby Gonzalez, one of the rising young stars in coaching.
74-70 win on the road for Manhattan. Miscommunication there. As Nash throws it away, Roy Williams is livid. He does not have many options off that bench. His team is down by three.
Hey, guys.
Carl, they continue to beat teams from bigger conferences, they do.
I'll tell you right now, Flores can play. One of my unsung heroes along last week with Mike DeMint. Coach of SMU would be Rice and Tulsa. Steve Morfell, coach down here, and beat Creighton with Evansville. As you look at Collison's numbers, 14 rebounds, a season high. I mean, he is playing with some unbelievable tenacity on the inside.
The All-American is playing like one here tonight, as is T.J. Ford, as was Heinrich toward the end of the first half. They need more offense from Heinrich here tonight. Inside, Klotz has been a monster off the bench tonight for Texas.
Well, he's been playing that way coming off the bench. Klotz and Boddicker. I mean, when you can bring quality big people like that to give you really good PT playing time, that's special.
Langford misses the 18-footer. Miles, Heinrich, and it's knocked away. Boddicker, the shooter, got the friendly bounce.
T.J. Ford knew where to go. He's coming down in transition. He looks right. He goes left to the shooter. He squares his body. Boddicker, he gets the roll. And Mr. Ford gets another assist.
Boddicker's 4-3 of the night.
He's got to shoot that shot, Miles. They're playing way off.
Collison trying to spin by the double team. And a good rebound inside for Boddicker.
That's great when you've got a guy like this, Dan. When you've got an orchestra leader, a maestro man. I call him an all-time Edison. He innovates, he creates. Oh, they stole it from left time.
Yeah.
I'm making him give
you
him
jinxed
a
him.
I'm giving him a lot of love, and he turns it over.
Turns it over to Aaron Miles. Let's see what Collison has in mind. A drive to the basket, and he draws the foul.
Roy Williams, 10 years an assistant down in North Carolina under Dean Smith. One of the greats ever to grace the Sable sideline. Wow, can you learn when you're on a staff like that? He was with Eddie Fogler and Bill Guthridge on that staff.
James Thomas coming back in with three fouls. Sidamil Harris returns to the game for the Longhorns as well. A guy who hit six threes against Notre Dame.
Nice lob
on the inbounds from Miles.
Nice look on the inside. Big momentum right there. I tell you, Thomas is a rebounding machine. He's a class eater.
Leads the Big 12.
King James.
Boddicker calling for it. Feeling it tonight with four threes.
A lot of poise. They're not intimidated by the crowd here.
Boddicker strip. Collison, good help.
What an environment. I'm telling you, my friends. You talk about Cameron Indoor Stadium. You talk about Allen Fieldhouse. They're just special places.
Miles taking Ford off the dribble. Collison on the follow.
Nick Collison giving everything he has. Pouring his heart out. Playing with spirit, enthusiasm. He said we were embarrassed by Arizona on our own floor.
T.J. Ford tries to answer and draws the foul on the drive. Nick Collison on his way to a monster night with 17 points and 15 rebounds.
Well, you notice what I expected of him. I picked him preseason. I'm an all-Rolls racer. He really started his season off slowly, wasn't active on the inside.
Remember at the beginning of the year, too, in New York City when we were there, Heinrich hurt his back. So now Gooden is gone, Boshi is gone. And Heinrich didn't play all that much for a couple of games because of the injury, so it all really fell on Nick Collison early.
Well, you know, he had one really bad game, and that was over at the Rose Garden when they lost to Oregon, when the two Lukes put a show on, Jackson and Rittenhour. Went for a big numbers and beat them 84-78, and then they ripped off 10 in a row, and Collison was absolutely sensational. They got a win over Cal. Cal's only got two losses, California.
They're terrific.
Yeah, they lost only two games. One to Georgia, one to Kansas. They're 7-0, and they got a battle with Arizona coming up on Saturday.
For more on Nick Collison, back to Andy Katz.
Well, Nick told me yesterday and today, the thing he misses the most about Wayne Simien is he can hit that 15-foot shot, so that creates a lot of space inside for him.
I'll tell you, Andy, he is working on the inside there. He's working almost just as hard as you are, Andy. And I know you're one of the tenacious battlers for information.
And remember, Nick Collison's not getting the rest every now and again that the Texas big guys are. There's nobody to take him out of the game.
You know what? He's not tired. He's physically strong. It's just a matter of he's got to stay away from foul trouble. This crowd is electric. I'll tell you, the enthusiasm is unbelievable.
Boddicker, another three-pointer.
Are you serious? Are you serious? What a college game. Boddicker showing that range from the trifecta.
Heinrich off the glass, knocks it down, takes a shot, but gets up and back into the play.
Kurt Heinrich and Collison trying to get the crowd totally into it. They don't want to lose, playing their hearts out. But do they have enough to beat this good, solid Texas team? Every time it looks like Kansas is going to make a run, Texas comes back with an answer.
Now they might continue that run here on the steal. Here comes Heinrich now at the point with Miles on the bench. Nash, oh my.
He got fouled. He got fouled. That's a four-point play. That's a four-point play. That's a no-no. Oh, they're jumping with joy at the Old Farm. They're jumping with joy at Allen Fieldhouse. Give me a break. This is unbelievable. Dan Schulman, your first time at the Farm.
Is it always like this?
It's always like this. Listen to this place.
Nash's fifth three of the season in 20 attempts. It was one of those shots when he put it up. You thought if he missed it, Roy Williams would take it out, but he knocked him down. Knocked it down, and he's going to the line with a chance to tie the game.
And Roy's looking at him like saying, I know you can do it, right?
No four-point play. The last lead for Kansas was at 10-7 with better than 16 minutes to go in the first half.
Heinrich, a good defensive player, now assigned to check four.
Tough cover there.
Oh, could be a lot of help. Can't play him one-on-one.
And a foul on Heinrich. Oh, look at what Roy Williams is saying. Oh, ball.
Oh, look at the pain. Look at the hurt. Sitting behind him is Steve Robinson, former head coach of Florida State. Now an assistant back here with Roy. Look at Rick Barnes. He got a smile on his face. He's not shaking at all. Rick's got a world of confidence.
Oh,
oh, look like ball there. Oh, look like ball there. Look ball, ball. Heinrich says, come on now. That could be a little break because the guy's an All-American.
Both guys are All-Americans.
Yeah. And one's at home. One's at home. You know, I mentioned Steve Robinson. As you look right here, it looks like all ball as an assistant. There are a lot of guys now, former head coaches as assistants. Larry Hunter at NC State, George Blaney at Connecticut, Ron Jersey at Dayton. They do a great job.
What a night of basketball here tonight. Brian Nash, Kansas, getting a boost off the bench. Back within three.
Wow, wow.
Roy Williams really getting on his kids in the huddle. Kansas is back within three of a very, very good Texas team. It could be closer, except this was called a foul on Kirk Heinrich. We have looked at it from a couple of angles.
You know, but these guys are doing a great job in a fast-paced game.
The pace of this game is unbelievable.
You know, it looks like a guy's making contact. It's nitpicking if you're going to jump on the official on that.
A look at the Hershey's game track. T.J. Ford will be prominently featured. Another spectacular game for him with 19 points and 8 assists. Texas unbeaten when leading at the half. Another big night for their bench. Their bench outscored Missouri's 22-0. On Saturday, Nick Collison, a huge game in Kansas, trying to avoid their first three-game losing streak in 9 years.
He's doing a great job posting inside. Collison really using his body, spreading it.
Great look for Heinrich. Can't get it to go, and the rebound to Mouton.
So much experience on that Texas team from last year. Depth.
Look at four. Collison might have gotten a fingertip on that shot. Here comes Heinrich. Michael Lee into the game and out for Kansas. Roy Williams again has to go into that bench. Keep people out of foul trouble.
I would slide it inside to Collison.
Langford with a long three, and Klotz holds off Collison with a rebound.
I would get the ball inside to him. He's so effective on the interior.
Ivy, no call there on Heinrich. Out of bounds to Texas. That might have been a makeup right there for Heinrich.
Has a look at James on that sideline. Big time rebounder in foul trouble. James Thomas.
Graves out with four for Kansas. Collison playing with three. Boddicker, Buckman, and Thomas all with three for Texas. Of those players, only Boddicker is on the floor.
I tell you, TJ, so graceful on his feet. I mean, just unbelievable measure. But behind, man, he's got that those feet. He just make music.
Except he's doing it with that basketball like it's on the end of a string.
Man. It's just, he's in control all the time. Yeah. You're at his mercy. As Digger said, you cannot play him one-on-one. Check him on. Look at that bounce pass. What a great look. I mean, how many guys can drill that bounce pass to a cutter to the goal? Ivy without the basketball, second time he's made that cut. And right on the money, man, he drops a dime. He's missed the TJ Ford.
Texas back up by five. Aaron Miles getting set to check back in for the Jayhawks. Collison calling for it. Nash with seven unexpected points off the bench tonight for Kansas. His career high is eight.
It's a big possession. Now they're up five on you. Got to knock it down, and Heinrich responds. Good medium-range jump shot. Great touch.
14 for the senior and the leader of the Kansas Jayhawks.
Man, that was a big possession because you're down five. You miss there. They go convert. You're in trouble.
Look at Ford sizing up Heinrich. Kicks it to a wide-open Boddicker. His sixth three-pointer of the night in seven tries.
I tell you, Boddicker knocking down the trifecta. They got guys that can shoot that. Certainly Harris, we have not seen shoot it today, can.
Knocked away. Mouton with a steal. Langford giving chase. And a finish for Mouton.
What a big-time play by Mouton. Very strong physically. Takes the ball to the basket with authority.
And the lead is back up to eight for the visiting Longhorns.
Okay, I'm so impressed with Texas, how they really are resilient. They never absolutely fold. Every time Kansas makes a run, they just respond. Take a look right now. A little shake and bake. He's going to dish the rock. And there's the jumper. Six trifectas. Mr. Boddicker, Andy.
And Boddicker, for the first time in his career, is finally feeling relaxed. That would have been the big problem. He was focusing too much on his shooting. He got a little bit lost in the game, started focusing on rebounding, defense, a little bit of everything, so he didn't focus so much on making every shot. And you can see here, he's as relaxed, and he's hitting all sorts of threes.
I'll tell you, if I was a shooter, I'd want to go play with TJ Ford, because he's going to get you some open looks.
Oh, that's a player's dream to play with a quarterback like that, because he's so unselfish.
Miles and Nyan back into the game and out for Kansas. Texas leading by eight. And Boddicker, I think, is going to get called for the foul, and that is his fourth. Big turn of events now for Texas as their outside shooter has to come out of the game, and James Thomas with three fouls will come back in.
Not bad, though, when you can substitute though Thomas for Boddicker, especially if you're looking for some rebound and some physical toughness down the stretch. You're going to see a little... He says, I didn't touch him. And that's a little Mickey Mouse right there, man, because the bottom line is they've been so physical inside all day.
Heinrich draws the foul. Tomorrow night, it's more great NCAA basketball action, Super Tuesday. As we take you to the Big Ten, it's all presented by Dollar Rent-A-Car. Number 20, Indiana taking on Michigan State. The Spartans have lost 6 out of 8 and are 2-4 in the league. They need a win. Number 4, Florida, unbeaten in the SEC down in Baton Rouge, taking on LSU.
You know, we talked about the Cameron Indoor Stadium. We certainly talked about here. But down there at the Breslin, the Izz Zone is certainly special. That place will be rocking tomorrow. And they got 8 losses. They need a win badly, Tom Izzo's club.
Both players trying to run it down. Collison and Thomas, and it will be Kansas basketball.
Getting to a danger time now for Kansas. As you get to the 8-minute mark, you're down 7. Every possession now becoming bigger and bigger. There's his dad, former coach, Dick Collison's dad. David coached him on a high school level.
As Kirk Heinrich's dad did him. Collison with a tremendous night. 19 points and 16 rebounds. Nice Heinrich screen. Gets free.
Great screen set by Collison. He sets the screen. Heinrich responds with the trifecta. I tell you, both big-time players have responded. They need a little help from their friends if they're to come back and beat Texas.
18 for Kirk Heinrich. TJ Ford, the miss. Collison battling underneath, comes up with it, and here comes Kansas.
What a great performance by Heinrich and Collison.
Miles, offensive foul.
Oh, what a big turnaround right there. See, I think Heinrich could have taken that right to the basket. Very unselfish.
An unbelievable game here in the Big 12 between Texas and Kansas, two national powerhouses, and we're seeing why here tonight.
Look at the hustle, look at the scrap, look at Collison giving it his all, pouring his heart out.
Hey guys. I'd like to start getting home to live.
Well, you won't see a better college basketball game than you're seeing here tonight from Allen Fieldhouse in Lawrence, Kansas. Big Monday presented by Bud Light here in the Big 12. Kansas on the shoulders, really, of their two All-Americans staying within striking range of a very talented Texas.
Well, their effort's certainly contagious to everyone around them. And without a supreme effort here, it'd probably be a blowout because Texas is really so talented. But Heinrich and Collison have keeping them within distance of catching them. Hey, I'll tell you a stat interesting. Kansas gets to the line big time. They've made 77 more free throws than their opponents, made 77 more than their opponents have attempted. But in a game against Arizona, they were 4 for 12, and Arizona was 22 for 26. Tonight, they're 13 for 18. Roy said that was a big concern.
Ford to Buckman, and a reach-in foul committed by Heinrich, it looks like. Yes, it is Kirk Heinrich. T.J. Ford once again initiating the offense for the Longhorns.
Take a look, a little handoff, and he's going to go explode right down the lane. Look at the vision. He spots him on the inside, and he's dishing a rock. I tell you, that's so reminiscent years ago with Phil Ford kicking it out to Mitch Kupchak. He had Kupchak, and he had Tommy Lagarde, Walter Davis. You don't remember this. You weren't even in.
Little pup. Andy Katz and I were. We were still in diapers back then.
I was coaching that. And when we got behind against North Carolina, I just waved the white handkerchief when it went to the four corners with Phil Ford.
Big miss at the free throw line. Kansas could inch a little bit closer.
Go inside to Collison.
One All-American to another. The Jayhawks back within two.
If they're going to win this game, those two got to carry them to the winner's circle. They got to give it all they have in the next 7 minutes.
Ford with a wild shot in the lane, but he draws the foul, and he'll go to the line.
I'll tell you, Ford, with his great penetration. I just love TJ. Look at his smile. Take a look right here at Collison. Now watch right now. We're going to watch him move without the basketball, slide right down the lane. Here he is inside. And look at this. He gets great position, angles really well, uses angles to get to the glass.
The senior schooled the freshman on that play. Ford back to the line for Texas.
Hey man, if you don't like TJ Ford, there's something wrong the way he plays. I can see Rick Barnes, who's done, as we said, an amazing job. He's at 10 NCAA berths at the four schools he worked at. He had some great stories today. He was on the staff with Gary Williams at one time down at Ohio State. I'll tell you, great, great praise for Gary. He's doing a fantastic job again with that Maryland program.
You're not kidding. Couple of free throws for Ford. He's got 21, and Texas up by four.
Every time they get a little close, Texas has a way of coming back.
Heinrich. Collison with another rebound.
That's going laterally for a rebound. That's special when you can go lateral across the lane.
That is his 19th rebound of the game.
Highest career high.
Yep. Back door, Heinrich, and he turns it over. But we've got a push down on the baseline, a call against Texas.
I tell you, he's got 19 rebounds, and everyone is needed. Rick Barnes had lots of praise for both Heinrich and Collison to be in the locker room before the game.
Number four on Thomas.
Now watch Collison go across the lane for this. That's a lateral rebound, man. That's running the basketball. Best rebounder I ever saw was Moses Malone.
Graves back into the game for Kansas with four fouls. Thomas will stay with four for Texas. With Graves on the bench, Kansas lost only 1 point to Texas in 9.5 minutes of play.
I'll tell you, a lot of that is the crowd here, man. This crowd wouldn't let this game get away from them.
What a game it's been here at Allen Fieldhouse in Lawrence, Kansas. Big Monday presented by Bud Light. Are we headed for another fantastic finish of the Big 12, as we've all seen the last couple of weeks? Look at the moves by Ford. He finds Mouton inside, and a travel on Brandon Mercer. Utah.
I tell you, what a wheeler and dealer though that kid TJ is. He's putting a show on. It's like watching the Cal concert. I mean, he is a showtime. What a pleasure to watch. Get it inside. Get Mr. Collison or Heinrich. You go down the wire with either one of the two shooting.
For the lead.
Yes, sir. Oh, baby. This is awesome, baby, with a Cal with the lead. Oh, and I love it. It's super scintillating, sensational. To this place.
Four on two. Miles.
Get a timeout. Get a T.O., baby. Rick Barnes better get a T.O.
You want to talk about a gutty performance. Kansas down as many as 13 in the first half. They have ridden the broad shoulders of Nick Collison's 24 points and 20 rebounds. They've got the lead with 5:47 to go. Bedlam here in Lawrence. This big comeback by the Jayhawks. They've got a three-point lead. It's the Texas Longhorns right now. A little bit unhappy with some of the officiating. And with more on that, here's Andy Katz.
Well, Texas coach Rick Barnes told T.J. Ford to go down to the opposite end of the court and talk to Ted Hillary and tell him when T.J. Ford gets bumped in the lane to call the foul.
He's giving a little hug. He's giving a little hug, a little love there.
Yeah, he'd rather the whistle than the hug, though. Ford. Over Miles. Ivy with a rebound. Collison with his 21st rebound.
That's amazing. 21 off the glass. And on the inside, he's had a battle of the likes of James Thomas, the leading rebounder in the Big 12. Big 12 basketball, man. I'm going to tell you, physical, talent, coaching.
A call against Klotz of Texas. Rick Barnes saying, what about the other end? What about the drive by Ford? Where's the foul down there?
Now we're going to find out how Texas responds.
You're right.
Come from behind. They've been in command most of the night. As you look at TJ trying to get into the 3-second area. There he is, then a little bit short on his shot. There he is, trying to get in the lane.
Every rebound. What a battle for every loose ball.
What a performance by the tandem inside-outside, Collison and Heinrich. Look at these numbers here. They're unbelievable. That's right. You're looking at 21 off the glass. 21 rebounds.
Of the 34 that Kansas has as a team. But this Texas team, they're not ranked third by accident. They're 13-2, and they are more than capable of winning this game. Foul trouble on both sides as Ivy drives on Heinrich, stumbles to a miss, and Miles has the rebound.
What a great defensive effort in that possession by Miles. He did not let T.J. Ford touch the basketball.
Langford for three. Ford the rebound. He's the got speed.
He's going to length of the court. Are you kidding? What an unbelievable move to get to the length of the basket.
And now a foul call, and it's the Jayhawk players in disbelief.
In the last position, did a great job at denying the ball. But look at T.J. Ford. He's going to rebound, and he's going to use that great quickness and ball handling skill to go right to the basket. Draws the contact, goes to the free throw line.
He's not only tough to defend, he's tough for the officials, too, the speed he plays the game.
You know, 10 assists as well as 6 rebounds.
The foul on Miles, by the way, his third.
What a winner he was on a high school level. Everybody predicted greatness for T.J. From the moment he put on a uniform for Rick Barnes, he's been nothing but a superstar.
Continues to knock him down.
I mean, the people down in Texas, in Austin, better enjoy this kid every moment they can and just flock out to see him. He's one in a million.
Langford gets free. Graves and Ford. Loose ball. Collison's got it, and he turns it over.
And look who comes up with the loose ball.
He's got help.
Are you kidding me? Some of those moves are unbelievable.
Wide open jumper. Graves rips it down.
I got to show some patience on the offensive end.
Miles. Heinrich, look out. Getting smothered. Getting grabbed. And a foul is the call.
You got to call a foul.
Jason Klotz called for the bear hug on Kirk Heinrich.
There's no doubt about it. He's making like Hulk Hogan, man. I mean, are you kidding? Watch this after he comes up with it. I mean, call the foul. Call the foul. He's taking him down. Call the foul. I mean, he's like Hulk Hogan. Oh, wow.
Nick Collison, an unbelievable performance tonight. Unable to get to the bench for more than a few seconds at a time. 24 points. 23 rebounds, and another report on him with Andy Katz.
Well, actually, Dan, that's the most rebounds in a single game by a KU player under Roy Williams.
And that's saying something, and he has battled for everyone. This is not some Division III school they're playing
here. This is not Cupcake City, my friend.
Look at the size Texas has, and that Collison has 23 boards.
And he's had some great players, Roy. He's had eight guys that were first-rounders in the NBA, including a friend, some poor peers.
And now he's got to cover Boddicker out of the perimeter. Mouton, yes, Mouton's had some big buckets here tonight.
Well, he's done that. The last seven games has been sensational. Averaging better than 14 a game. Now you get down to patience and poise as you come down to winning time. Making free throws is going to be essential if you want to get a win here in the last 3 minutes.
Collison forcing the issue, and the call is going to go against him as Boddicker takes the charge. A big finish on the way again. So what else is new here on Big Monday? Steve Levy, Linda Cohn standing by with SportsCenter. Sean Marion taking on Michael Jordan tonight. Is Steve Mariucci heading back to his home state? And could the Bucks, could your Bucks be even better next year? Hard to fathom that after the performance they had last night. Hard to imagine a better game than we have seen here tonight between Texas and Kansas. The Longhorns were up by as many as 13 in the first half. Unbelievable performance by Nick Collison. Kansas leads, but for Kansas, Graves and Collison each with four fouls. For Texas, Klotz, Boddicker, and Thomas all have four fouls. Boddicker and Thomas are in the game. Klotz is on the bench.
Right now, you got to try to attack inside against Collison with four. They can't possibly have him go to the sideline.
Got a tough cover on Boddicker, who can take you inside and then take you outside. Here he is. Baseline over Heinrich. The pass hit the underside of the backboard, and that turns it over to Kansas.
Yeah, poor job in that possession by Texas. Didn't do a great job. I think they got some great recruits coming in here next year, though. When you look at Kansas, they got Jamal Wilkes' son from out of UCLA. Wilkes, they got a kid named David Padgett, J.R. Giddings, Jeremy Case. What a great recruiting class for the Jayhawks.
Heinrich gets a step on Ivy and knocks it down.
What a great job by Heinrich moving without the ball, getting into the 3-second area for that little curl move. What a performance by Heinrich and Collison.
25 points for Kirk Heinrich tonight.
As good as a 1-2 combination I've seen this year before.
Kansas on the run. Heinrich again in a block. Now it's Ford's turn.
The clock, smart play by Aaron Miles, and the house here loves it. What a phenomenal game we are witnessing tonight, Dan.
Given the loss at Colorado and then the 37-point swing against Arizona, a win here for Kansas, if they can do it, this would be monumental for them.
Well, it's a big game for them. It's significant. They need this win.
Mouton can't finish, and it's Kansas ball.
Kansas lost two streaks last week, 25 in a row at home and 23 consecutive Big 12 games. Look at Graves. He says, thou shalt not bring it in the lane, little guy.
Boy, that's great timing.
Response. He's not a great shooter, but he's a winner, man. He's a winner.
Largest lead of the night for Kansas. Ford answers to make it a 4-point game, and Rick Barnes will use a timeout.
TJ Ford playing his heart out for Texas. Heinrich and Collison, what an unbelievable performance. What a tandem tonight they have been. We said earlier this year, the best tandem in America. Collison and Heinrich, but here's Miles now. The point guard responded. Nobody checking. There he is. Nobody checking him in an old story. Anything you can do, I can do better, says TJ. There's that little bounce off the floor with those soft, soft feet. So quick, so explosive.
T.J. Ford has matched his career high with 25 points, but they might need a few more if they're going to win this game. Well, stick around for more great basketball action coming your way at midnight Eastern tonight as Big Monday presented by Bud Light rolls into Game 3. UNLV against New Mexico 1 hour from now. UConn defeated St. John's in the first game tonight. Aaron Miles stepping it up against his buddy, an All-American, in T.J. Ford. 15 points and 9 assists. Ford has 25 points and 10 assists.
You know, Miles was 0 for 7 against Arizona. Gardner and Stoudemire were phenomenal.
Boy, a lot of contact there. Miles might have gotten away with an offensive foul. As it is, Texas has the ball.
Just put it in his hands and everybody else get ready for a dish or he'll take it and score.
Taking it himself, rolls around and out. Wave off the basket, the foul before the basket. Who's it going to be?
Barnes really upset with that. He thought they definitely had the good offensive rebound.
Is it Collison? Nick Collison, a magnificent performance tonight with 24 points and a career-high 23 rebounds, has fouled out of the game.
There he is, over the top. They got contact. Tommy O'Neill with the call. Just a magnificent performance. I mean, when he goes to that sideline, you're going to hear a thunderous roar. This game goes to overtime. It certainly would be an edge for Texas. No doubt they would have the edge, even though they're playing on the road. What a performance by Nikos. He doesn't want to leave, man. He's had such a great game. He says, I don't want to leave. He said, guys, win it for me. Hey, I'm going to stand up. That was an unbelievable performance. I don't do this too much, Mr. Schulman. I don't do this too much. That effort tonight was absolutely awesome. I mean, that was awesome. I stood one other time for David Robinson against Kentucky years ago. Great performance, son. I mean, that was unbelievable.
James Thomas at the line. Maybe the best game that Nick Collison has ever had in a Kansas uniform, and that is saying something. Remember, consider the opposition, too, that he's done this against.
And believe me, I don't care who wins the basketball game. I just love and appreciate great efforts, and I'd stand for TJ if he found out the way he played here tonight. What a phenomenal performance by Collison.
And what an outstanding game it has been from the moment it began 2 hours ago. Kansas ball through the hands of Graves, through the hands of Boddicker, out of bounds. Steve Levy, Linda Combe with SportsCenter. As soon as this game is over, timeout Kansas. Collison out. Jayhawks lead, a minute 16 to play.
You know, Rick Barnes has done it. We talked about Roy, but the job he's done with that Texas program's amazing. Next year he's got some great kids, P.J. Tucker coming in, and kid named Edgar Marino. So the beat is going on and on. They really renovated their facility.
You talked about how important it is for all Americans to play that way. T.J. Ford has done it, Kirk Heinrich has done it, and maybe more than anybody, Nick Collison has.
Yeah, they've all responded, and that's what you have to appreciate. And I'll give a standing ovation to any kid that pours his heart out. What we witnessed here tonight, this guy just poured his heart out, and so did T.J. on the other side. It's just been a masterful effort. The energy as you look at Collison, this great basketball play. Career high of rebounding tonight by Collison.
Kansas has the ball and a 3-point lead with a minute 16 to play. Timeouts remain for both teams.
No different in styles, almost reminiscent of the effort we saw by Tom Coverdale when he did not allow Indiana to lose to Maryland earlier this year, where he just poured his heart out and willed his team for the victory. And that's what we witnessed here tonight thus far with Nick Collison. The question is, do they have enough to win this basketball game with 50 ticks on the clock and up three?
And the shot clock down to 7. Heinrich, wide open. Miles. And a big rebound for Thomas. Gets it back, and Ford's got the ball.
Thomas just a man on the inside. A born glass eater.
Don't need the three.
I go inside now. Thomas will touch. That's a turnover. That's a turnover. There's no doubt about it. No doubt about it. Good call by Tommy O'Neill.
Mouton saying he kept his hand on top of the ball.
No way. No way. That ball comes over. Never kept it on time.
Texas calls a timeout.
And you know your credit if Kansas wins this game? Certainly the effort, the coaching ability of Roy Williams. Don't you forget the Rock Chalk Jayhawk fans. These fans were absolutely fantastic here tonight.
We talked about some of the big finishes on Big Monday here in the Big 12 2 weeks ago. The controversial shot by Victor Williams had the shot clock expired with 3.5 seconds to go in the game as the Cowboys beat the Sooners. Then who will ever forget this wild drive by Hollis Price last week, forcing overtime and leading Oklahoma to an eventual win over Texas Tech. Are we headed for another last-second finish in this unbelievable conference as Texas tries to stay undefeated in league play and Kansas tries to get to 4-1 and within a game of the lead?
And you look at Oklahoma at 4-1 with Mr. Clutch. Hollis Price, one of the clutch performers in basketball. They can get 7 teams possibly in a tournament this year. Colorado, if they get a little bit hot, they have a chance. I mean, they have a chance. They got one loss at home to only Georgia.
Texas will wrap up Michael Lee and force him to the free throw line. Remember, Lee does not play all that much. He's a 69% shooter on the season. Sports Center with Steve Levy and Linda Cohn coming up next here on ESPN.
And so many games won in special situations now. You talk about the free throw line late in the game. It's very important you convert. Right now, you got a one possession game. If he at least makes one, he makes it a two possession game. As Nick Hollis is sitting out, they don't want this baby to go to OT with him sitting out. Look at those numbers, 24 and 23.
Lee's first trip to the line tonight.
Some inside players go all month to get 23 rebounds. Big free throw, big free throw. Played together with Miles in high school. Fans show their appreciation. Roy Williams, we talked about it, 27 wins a year, 15th year at Kansas. Has built such a program, one of the elite programs in America. And Rick Barnes is starting to do that with the Texas program. Dave, money, ice. We got ice. Timeout. Got a 5-point game. Still some time in that
there program. There is. Anybody who's been watching Big Monday knows there's plenty of time left.
And you can't think about a three right now. You get the first quick basket you can get.
Last year's game between these two teams, just as wild. It was down in Austin. The game featured 11 ties and 10 lead changes. Just about a year ago, Royale Ivy shot with 31 seconds left, tied the game at 96. They went to overtime after Kirk Heinrich and Aaron Miles each missed shots that would have won it for the Jayhawks. So they go to overtime, and in the overtime, Kansas connects on all 5 shots and wins 110 to 103.
I think a little different than what we saw on Saturday night in terms of the defensive effort by Kentucky. And certainly don't underestimate their defensive effort being special.
Deafening noise and just a wonderful atmosphere here in Lawrence, Kansas for as good a college game as you'll ever see.
See, right now, you're going to attack the basket, get a quick deuce, and then try to steal.
Boddicker for 3. Maybe a lob inside for Thomas, who's fouled. If it's Graves from behind, then he's gone.
Not a good play. You stop the clock. You stop the clock, you get your 5th foul. Not a good play. You got to understand. A lot of times kids do not understand time and situation. You got to understand the time and the situation of a game. Now, here it is. There's the contact. Graves says, no, I just stood there. I extended my hands.
So Collison is out. Graves is out. Simeon, of course, is hurt, which is why Graves
front court
has become so important. They do not have much size at all. It's going to be Bryant Nash at 6'6", about 205 pounds, who will come in and be the inside guy for Kansas, playing with 4 guards.
But what they have on their side right now is 16 ticks on a clock and a 5-point lead and some rabid fans going bananas. I mean, you got to like their situation, even though right now there's certainly a chance if he converts these two.
30-second timeout taken by Roy Williams. What a game.
It's just been a fantastic evening here. I mean, an unbelievable setting. I know tomorrow it'll be rocking when we go down into his zone, Michigan State and Indiana. And this is why I love college hoops, man. I'm going to tell you something. Every game, it just makes you feel young. 63, and I act 12, my friend. And you're losing it all
I'm going to be 63 pretty soon,
you're losing it all like me.
hey, talk about Kane. You asked Roy Williams before the game, what did you do in practice yesterday? How do you respond to that Arizona loss? How did he get his team ready for this game?
Well, he just simply said, hey, if we lose tonight to Texas, I don't want it to be because of an effort and because we're thinking of the game against Arizona. Good teams have a way to put that away and get ready to play. They were ready to play tonight. And Rick Barnes told me, he said, we are going to get every shot they have tonight. They're an angry team, man. They lost two in a row, have not lost three in a row since 1994.
The two best teams in Big 12 play in conference in the last 4.5 years, just a game ahead of Oklahoma, who's third. The Texas Longhorns becoming a national powerhouse in a hurry, but they're up against it here. Thomas is going to shoot a couple of free throws. Rick Barnes wants to get a sub in. And Royal Ivy is going to be allowed, I believe, to check into the game. They want to play a little offense-defense here. Boddicker's going to come out. They'll get back him back in when they get the ball back because he's one of their best three-point shooters.
Well, you can talk all you want about substitutions. It comes down to now. He must convert these two to make it a one-possession game and try to go for the steal and then foul to stop the clock and hope they miss. You don't have to be a genius. A dummy like myself can figure out how big this is.
Sports Center next, UNLV, New Mexico at the top of the hour.
Linda and Steve waiting there. What a combination. They are in the backcourt getting ready for Sports Center. And I'm sure there'll be some highlights in this game. That's a big, big two. Big two. Now you got to try to play for the steal. Go for defense here. Face guard. They're leaving the guy alone on the baseline. 5 against 4. Smart play by Barnes, trying to get the steal here. Want to keep it out of Heinrich's hands.
Oh, Miles almost turned it over.
Oh, he grabbed it.
Yeah.
He grabbed it.
And Langford is going to go to the line.
They wanted to make certain to keep the ball away from Heinrich, Texas.
Yeah, the blue shoes that he changed into at halftime. If the first half doesn't go well.
Look at my blue suede shoes.
Nice, huh? We got to get him and Antoine Petway of Alabama together with the red shoes. But Langford, he's going to get 2 free throws. It's double bonus. But he has not shot a free throw here tonight. There,
look at the shoes. Look at those shoes. First half shoes. I mean, the kid's got all kinds of style, man. He's got all kinds. I'm going to call him Shoes Langford. Laid out McGuire one time, labeled the kid that at Michigan State. All them shoes. I love Al. I miss him so much.
Oh, boy.
This big right now.
Yep.
This big right now.
Here comes Boddicker, the three-point shooter. Here comes Thomas, the big man.
This could be the game right here. He knocks this down. They're in pretty good shape. Unless you have a scoop and a miracle happens. If he converts this to give that 4-point differential, there's a major difference with 3 and 4.
Quiet, quiet, quiet.
Does he get the bounce? Doesn't get it. They got a shot.
Texas can tie.
They got a shot, Boddicker. You got it. Can shoot it.
The three doesn't go for Harris. They get the rebound, though. Ford. And Kansas wins.
Oh, what a performance by Collison and Heinrich. Will not let them lose. And Miles, just a great college game. You'd have thought they won the national championship. Well, they don't lose 3 in a row, Mr. Schulman. Everybody was talking about that.
Last time was 9 years ago. They're on the floor here at Allen Fieldhouse as the Kansas Jayhawks snap their 2-game losing streak with an incredible 90 to 80. 97 win over Texas. Nick Collison, 24 points, 23 rebounds. Kirk Heinrich with 25 for the Jayhawks, offsetting an incredible performance by T.J. Ford for Texas. Andy Katz standing by with Nick Collison.
Nick, you had 24 points, 23 rebounds. You're out here for an hour by yourself today. What was the difference in your game from today, from Saturday?
I was just a lot more aggressive. I came out from the opening tip trying to score, and yesterday against Arizona, I was a little too passive, I think. I was just looking for my shot more.
How much did this team need this win?
We needed a lot. It would have been tough to lose three in a row. I've only lost like three games at home my whole career, so two in a row would have been tough, but it's a big win today.
Congratulations, Nick.
Nick Collison, one of the best games we've seen by any college player this season, as Kansas wins 90-87 in a tremendous game here at Lawrence. For Dick Vitale, Andy Katz, and the crew, I'm Dan Shulman. Thanks for watching. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. Steve Levy, Linda Cohn.